As we move into this operations, one of the things we want to stress is safety. We still have a lot of power lines that are on the grounds, a lot of debris in the roads, and that's one of the reasons we're kind of keeping the public out of it until we can get these things removed from the road and make sure we got a safe environment for people to go home to. Right now, like I say, it's all about safety and getting the incident scene back to the point where the residents can go home and assess their own damages and be able to begin the recovery process. We're going to continue working with fire rescue and the damage assessment teams today as these lines get picked up to get an idea of how many impacts we have here, how many structures are impacted, and what the overall impact is from this tornado. Any questions, or just Sheriff?
Sure.
Okay. Well, first off, everyone, welcome to sunny Florida. You know, hope everybody brought a coat. Listen, first off, I want to say we appreciate you being here today and assisting us in getting the word out to the to our community. We always partner with the press. You know, you're one of the vehicles that we use for, you know, for safety issues. Ran into many of you this morning on scene before the sun came up. I appreciate your, you know, your indulgence of us getting you out of that area at that time. I want to assure everybody that we're going to work as quickly as we can today with the county, with Gulf Power and everyone else to get the roadways cleared. You know, make sure all utilities are off, all gas is off. We got some propane, you know, tank issues that we need to look at. And at that time, we'll get you into the areas to get you better coverage of the devastated areas as soon as possible. But again, you know, we beg your indulgence in this. Remember, our goal is, you know, the safety of our citizens, the safety of our first responders, and most assuredly your safety when you come in to do your job, you know, to report to the nation on what's occurring in Escambia County. So welcome. You know, we're honored to have you here. And of course, we're honored to have both the mayor of Pensacola, Ashton Hayward, with us, and most assuredly our governor of the state of Florida, Rick Scott. So Governor Scott, to you, sir.
Well, we just flew in to assess the damage. I talked to the sheriff earlier this morning and got a report from him, and he was out where the most of the damage was, close to the apartment complex mooring. We've been told that so far we believe there's 70 plus homes that are damaged. We have about 2,700 homes without power right now, but Stan Conley and the team at Gulf Power are working hard to make sure everybody gets the power back that we can quickly. The most important thing that the sheriff will say, emergency management teams will say, the mayor will say, is we're here to make sure everybody gets back to living a normal life as quickly as we can. The city's going to do their job, the county's going to do their job, the state's going to do their job, and we're going to make sure any resources we can get from the federal government, we make that happen. All of us would say our heart goes out to anybody impacted by this. You can't imagine going through this with your family, with your children. Fortunately, we've only had three individuals that have been taken to hospitals right now. We believe right now that their injuries are minor. So we're hopeful for them that's all going to go fine. But we're going to continue to assess the damage and get people back to living their lives as quickly as we can. So thank you for being here. And as like the sheriff said, thank you for helping get the message out. We've got to keep everybody safe. It's very, very important that we don't end up getting through this without any significant health issues, and then somebody gets hurt after the fact.
I want to thank the media, because in times like this, when a crisis happens, we can't do it without the media. And we all know safety's number one. And obviously the collaboration with Governor Rick Scott, with Jack Brown, the sheriff, our chief of police, our county commissioners, Doug Underhill's here from the southwest part of the county. But most importantly, our first responders are critical. But working with the power company and law enforcement. But again, having the media here to get the messaging out is incredibly important, and that the city and county work together. And again, we can't thank Rick Scott enough for what he's done to step up every time we've had one of these disasters recently. As we all know, I'm sure the media is asking, tornadoes twice, flood, ice storms. It's incredible. So again, working together is incredibly important. So again, thank you for being here.
Now, just really briefly, I want to mention that you know, we know that here in Escambia County, we're a very collaborative county. We work together. When things like this happen, everybody in the county rushes and wants to help. For those that want to help, and we've had a lot of volunteers showing up, understand that the site is not yet safe for volunteers to go in and help. American Red Cross is going to be leading all of the volunteer assistance. So if you have resources, if you want to help, contact the American Red Cross. They're the ones that will be able to get you dialed in and lined up. Thanks a lot.
As the mayor said, you know, we've had floods, we've had ice storms, now we've had these tornadoes, but you've got a great emergency management team locally. The sheriff's department does a great job. The mayor's team does a great job. Everybody involved here, they really work well together and get things done. And I can just say from the state standpoint, Brian Coons here that runs the state emergency management team, we're going to do the right things for each of these families. I'll be going up to Century. I'm going to head up to Century today to meet with individuals up there. We've already declared a state of emergency up there. We've already providing some funds from the state budget up there now. And so we'll continue to be doing things to try to help them get back. The sheriff kept me informed the last week, the emergency management did, and you just can't imagine this happening.